Today we're gonna see how we can create the time glitch effect in Final Cut Pro 10 without any plugins required. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more content like this one. Before starting with the tutorial, I want to say a huge thank you to Lili Kutsandrea, she's the dancer that you saw in the beginning of this video. Let's go into Final Cut Pro 10 now. We're in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface, and this is the timeline of the video you saw in the beginning. Now, I'm gonna go and select some parts and break it down to show you how we can create this effect. So let's go with the first clip, as you can see here. The basic idea of the time glitch effect, and this is an effect that is inspired by the Lil Uzi Vert Futsal Shuffle video clip, is to break the video to create time differences. So let's go and see in action. We have the clip, and let's say that we want the first effect to take place here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna press B in my keyboard, I'm gonna create a cut here, I'm gonna select the next clip, and I'm gonna press Option F, so I can have a frame. The other way to do that, if you don't want to press Option F, is by go to Edit and add Freeze Frame. Now I'm gonna go to the Freeze Frame and I'm gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4 frames with the right arrow in my keyboard. You can play with that and you can count between 3 to 6 frames to match your own taste. Then what I'm gonna do, again selecting B, I'm cutting the frame here. Now I'm gonna go to the video and I'm gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4 frames, and I'm gonna drag the video and edit here. One tip, you can count the frames, but also, let me undo this, if you see here and you drag, you have on the left the frame where it stopped, so you can say where you want the next jump to take place, because we're previewing this on the right side of the screen. So we can either count 3 to 6 frames with the right arrow in our keyboard, as we did with the freeze frame, or here we can match where we want the time glitch effect to stop by previewing when we're dragging the video on the left, and on the right we see here these two windows. Let me just make the preview window bigger. So if we play now, we see that we already have this time glitch break, and we will continue doing this effect for the rest of the clip. This effect works best with movement, so we need our subject or the dancer to have a movement on the hands or the feet to show the effect better. I'm gonna continue now. Let's say here again, I'm blading, selecting the other one, add freeze frame. Now I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3 frames, not 4. I'm deleting this. And as you can see, as I'm scrolling down, I wanna continue here. Continue with the same process. We can also press Command B, where our line is, to avoid pressing B to cut into our video. Again, Option F, 1, 2, 3 frames this time, removing this. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's have a bigger gap here. Okay, and let's finish that. You can continue. You got the idea of this effect. This is the first step. The second step is to add some effects where the glitch time breaks happen. And because we don't want to place them into the video or the freeze frames, we're gonna use adjustment layers. And if you don't have adjustment layers, you can click on the link in the description of this video to download for free, and also check the video that it's appearing right now to learn more about the adjustment layers. So we click on titles and we bring a basic adjustment layer. Let's break it here. Let's bring it after the first freeze frame. I'm gonna make the duration same as the video above. And then the first effect that we're gonna do, we're going to the effects panel, we're typing prism, and we're dragging it and place it on the adjustment layer so we can have the prism effect. And we will set the amount to 10. And the second effect that we wanna drag is the trails. We will hit trails, and that way we're gonna have some echoes. And we will set the trails to 0.05. You can play with 0.05 so you can have a bigger motion on the trails, or 0.02 where you don't want a lot of motion trail in the movement, and the echoes number is gonna be 2. Remember that all these settings can be changed to match your own taste. After we finish with this adjustment layer, we will press the Option key on our keyboard, and with a click we're gonna duplicate it, and we can either match the video, or we can either match between the video and the freeze frame. So you can play around with either the two of these options. And let's play the video to see what we have created. One last step that you can do is to play with the speed rubbing on your videos between the freeze frames. And let me just bring another clip to show you. And we have the next video. What I'm gonna do here, again, I'm gonna start with the same process as the beginning. Now I have the cursor, I'm gonna press Command B to create the cut, Option F to create the freeze frame, 1, 2, 3 frames, blading again, removing this, and counting 1, 2, 3. And let's do one more here. The same process, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frames. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is go to the end here. I'm gonna press R in my keyboard. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit with Command Plus, and I'm gonna select the last frame, and I'm gonna change the speed to 25%. And also I will go here, and I'm gonna make it the speed ramp to be more fast. And then at the beginning, after the freeze frame, I'm gonna select 3 frames, and I'm gonna change the speed to 4 times faster. You can either go with slow to fast, slow to slow, fast to slow, etc. You can play with it and change it to whichever speed you like. Again, I'm gonna copy the adjustment layers that have the effects, and now I'm gonna cover and the freeze frame and the video at the beginning and at the end, and the result is gonna look like this. You can play with this, you can make the freeze frame a little bit shorter, or the freeze frame a little bit longer. And now one last tip, if you want the chromatic aberration that we created with the prism to have the movement that we saw in the Lil Uzi Vert video clip, you will have to keyframes here the angle for each frame. So, for example, as you can see here on this adjustment layer on top, what I've done is to add a keyframe and then go right one frame and set it to 180 degrees. And then again, go back to 0, and then again to 180 for all the frames until the adjustment layer ends. And what you'll see is gonna be this wiggle that you saw in the video in the beginning. Lastly, if you want your effect to have a motion blur as well, you can download for free the motion blur free package that I have in the description of this video down below. But I'm sure that you got the idea of how you can play with this very easy and very special effect, especially for video clips and dance videos. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. And if you did, don't forget to like this video, and also, I'm waiting for your comments. You can imagine how important it is for me to receive comments from my viewers and learn what you would like to see next, or just show me their support. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.